Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this sixth video class of DIP, we will study image sampling and quantization. So as usual, starting with the name itself, what is the meaning of sampling? Sampling means the process of dividing into small parts or samples. And what is the meaning of quantization? Quantization means to restrict to discrete values rather than to a continuous set of values. That means image sampling and quantization means sampling the image into small parts and restricting the values of these smaller parts to discrete values rather than continuous set of values, right? So let us start. So we know that an image is basically a two-dimensional representation of a three-dimensional world. The basic requirement for image processing is that image obtained should be in the digital form. For example, we cannot work with or process photographs on identity card unless we scan it using a scanner. So the scanner digitizes the photograph and stores it on the hard disk of the computer. Once this is done, one can use image processing techniques to modify the image as per the requirement. Hence, digital image processing is only possible when we digitize the analog pictures, right? See, now that we have understood the importance of digitization, let us see what the term actually means. See, the process of digitization involves two steps, sampling and quantization. So in other words, you can say that digitization is equal to sampling plus quantization, right? So sampling and quantization are two important processes used to convert continuous analog image into digital image. Image sampling refers to discretization of spatial coordinates, that is along x-axis and y-axis, right? Whereas quantization refers to discretization of gray level value. So image sampling refers to discretization of spatial coordinates, that is x and y coordinates, right? Whereas quantization refers to discretization of gray level values or intensity values or amplitude values. So given a continuous image f of xy, digitizing the coordinate values is called sampling, and digitizing the amplitude or intensity values is called quantization. Okay. So remember, when we are digitizing the coordinate values, it is called sampling for digital image processing. And when we are digitizing the amplitude or intensity or gray level values, it is known as quantization, right? So spatial resolution means the sampling resolution, right? And intensity resolution means the quantization resolution. So spatial resolution means the sampling resolution, how many samples you are taking and you are resolving into finer details, and quantization resolution means the intensity resolution or gray level resolution, right? So say this is the object which we want to scan and digitize for digital image processing. So we need to do sampling and quantization with this object. Say we are doing the sampling and quantization along the line A, B of this particular image. So the one dimensional function shown in this figure is a plot of amplitude or gray level values of the continuous image along the line segment A, B. So you can see how this particular scanning line A, B is. From the starting point up to the border of the object, the line A is having complete white values, okay, and you know that white is represented by 255 for 8-bit image or 1 for a binary image, right? And black is represented by 0. At the border, the image becomes dark suddenly, okay, and as you go ahead in the line, you can see that the image becomes gradually white, okay, not completely white but having very light shades of gray starting from the very dark black. And after that, the image again start becoming dark from very light shades of gray, or near to the border it becomes very dark, and after the border you can see it again becomes complete white. So the one dimensional function shown here is a plot of amplitude or gray level values of the continuous image along the line segment AB. So you can see here for A up to the border of the object, it is complete white. or maximum level, that is 255 for an 8-bit image. Then at the border, it suddenly drops to a black value, dark value. After that, it again becomes lighter towards the mid of the line, and then it again starts becoming darker. So at the border of this object, again the line becomes complete white. So the one dimensional function which is shown in this figure is a plot of amplitude or gray level values of the continuous image along the line segment AB, which is shown in this particular figure. The random variation which you can observe here is due to the image noise. To sample this function, we take equally spaced sample along the line AB as it is shown here, right? So we are taking equally spaced sample which are denoted by this horizontal marking which are shown over here. In order to form a digital function, the gray level values also must be converted or quantized into discrete quantities. Here we are only quantizing the coordinate values, but the gray level or intensity values must also be quantized and converted into discrete quantities. So this right side shows the gray level scale divided into 8 discrete values ranging from black to white, and we will be assigning each value to the sample as per this scale. So that means that this particular sample will be assigned dark intensity value. These samples which are shown here, these 4 samples as well as these 4 samples, will be assigned the white level of intensity. These samples which are shown here will be assigned this particular gray level. This sample will be assigned this particular gray level, and so on. And this is how we quantize image, or we assign intensity values to the samples we have taken for the particular line. Getting it? Okay. So the result of both sampling and quantization is shown in this figure, right? So here you can only see the samples but not the complete line. The samples will be having values from this particular scale. So this is how you digitize the object along line AB, that is one dimensional. Scanning number of lines from top to bottom will result in a two-dimensional image, that is shown over here. So this two-dimensional digital image can also be obtained by using sensor array. Okay, and remember, as we have already mentioned in the earlier classes, that digitization is always an approximation of the real value. Okay, it is never equal to the real values or real analog image, because analog image will be having infinite number of values, right? So here we will be discretizing, and we will be neglecting some of the values, and therefore digitization is always an approximation of the real image. So here you can see from this image, okay, that we have chosen these two values, okay, as the dark values complete like this, whereas you can see this particular square is having half white, but still we have considered it as full black. Here majority of the portion is white and very little is black, so we have considered it as a white, black is omitted. Similarly, different portions of the image are digitized, and you can see here that a number of details are also lost in digitization, right? But when we increase the sampling to a very large value, the digital image obtained will be approximately same as the original image. Let us go ahead and understand the representation of a digital image. So we have already seen the coordinate convention to represent the digital images in the very first video lecture of DIP. An image can be defined as a two-dimensional function f of xy, where x and y are spatial or plane coordinates, and amplitude of f at any pair of coordinates x comma y is called the intensity level or gray level of the image at that particular point. So for this image that is converted into a digital form, okay, one square in this image is 1 pixel or picture element or PEL, which is the smallest discriminable part of a digital image. This digital image is composed of a finite number of elements which are referred to as picture elements, image elements, PELs or pixels, and pixel is a term most widely used to denote the elements of a digital image. So we can represent a m cross n digital image as a compact matrix like this, when x, that is the row value or row coordinate, y, that is the column value or the column coordinate, and the amplitude values of f are all finite discrete quantities, we call the image a digital image. The field of digital image processing refers to processing digital images by means of a digital computer. Okay, let's go ahead. So we represent any digital image by the number of bits. Okay, so if k is the number of bits per pixel, then the number of gray levels L is an integer power of 2, that is L is equal to 2 raised to k. So the number of gray levels L is equal to 2 raised to k, where k is the bit size of the image. For example, for a 8-bit image, right, it is L is equal to 2 raised to 8, that is 256. And for a binary image which is having only 1 bit and 2 values, right, L is equal to 2 raised to 1, which is equal to 2, and it is having only 2 values, that is black and white. So when an image can have gray levels, it is common practice to refer to an image as a k bit image, right? So we call an image as a 8 bit image or 16 bit image or 4 bit image or 1 bit image. For example, an image with 256 possible gray level values is called an 8 bit image. Therefore, the number of bits required to store a digitized image of size m cross n is given by b is equal to m into n into k, where m and n are the number of pixels and k is the bit size of the image. Okay, so let us solve one example. How much storage capacity is required to store an image with size 1024 cross 768 and 256 gray levels? Okay, so see, as the gray levels are 256, okay, it is an 8 bit image. Why? Because 2 raised to 8 is equal to 256, right? So that means your k over here is 8. So the storage capacity that is required is equal to m into n, that is 1024 into 768 into k bit, and here it is 8 bit, right? So into 8, which gives 6291456 bits, which is equal to 786432 bytes. Okay, if you divide this number of bits by 8 bits, that is 8 bits is equal to 1 byte. So if you divide by 8, you will get 786432 bytes, right? Which is equal to, you can say, 786.432 kilobyte, right? So this image will be having a size of 786.4 KB. If it is a color image in place of grayscale image, we further have to multiply M cross N cross K by 3 for 3 different planes R, G and B of a color image. So that is how you measure the size of the image, as well as that is how you find out the storage capacity that is required to store an image. Getting it? Okay. So that is all for this video class. In the next class, we will study spatial resolution, that is coordinate resolution, and intensity resolution, that is the gray level resolution, and also its implementation in MATLAB. Okay, but remember that spatial resolution is related to sampling and intensity resolution is related to quantization. Okay, thank you.